This screencast will show you how to edit a picture using iPhoto 11. First thing you do is you find the picture you would like to edit and you double click it. And now you can see your picture. If you would like to see it full screen, you can click the full screen button. And I like to do that. And then I can click edit. And I will get quick fixes, effects, and adjust. I can rotate my picture. I can do an enhance of my picture. And you can decide if you like that or not. If you do not like it, you can undo. I use Command Z to undo, or you can use the undo button here. And it'll bring your picture back to what you had previously. That works for all of these fixes too. If you do not like something, undo. If you've done a lot of things to it and you do not like them, you can revert to the original and it'll take you back to the original picture you had. So don't be afraid to try things. If you have red eye, you can click Fix Red Eye. And it's nice because it can auto fix the red eye or you can manually do it. You can straighten. This happens a lot, especially with children. They take pictures and they're sideways. This brings up this tab and you can adjust the angle. And you can slide it. It does crop the picture a little bit, but it makes your picture straight if you need it. You can crop your picture. You can tell it to constrain it to a certain size. If you're printing your pictures, you'd probably want to do this. Click Constrain, Constrain. And then you can choose which size you want. If you're printing 4x6s, I would pick 4x6 or 5x7 or 8x10 and so forth. You can crop it to the size of your display, but I'm just going to leave it at the original. You can also turn off constraint and then you can crop it any way you like. So if we just want a little bit, we can do that. Remember, if you crop too much, you may lose image quality. If you have a very high quality camera, that probably won't happen. The only time you lose quality with a real high quality camera is if you are printing them out at a real large size. But for most purposes, cropping is fine. So if I like that, I can constrain it and then I can click done. And now I have my cropped picture. I can remember I can undo it and bring it back. If I want to retouch my image, I can click that and I can drag over parts that I think don't look good. Blemishes, dust, and that looked pretty bad. Oh, that looked pretty good. That looks pretty bad. So I'm going to undo that. Most of the time I do not use retouch, but you can try it out. Effects are always nice. You can lighten a picture. You can darken the picture. You can do auto contrast. Warmer and cooler. This helps a lot. Sometimes your pictures will be very blue depending on what kind of light you take it in. And you can make it warmer with that. And the saturation is here as well. You can easily do black and white. Turn it on and off. And sepia. Antique is a nice look to make it look like an old picture, and you can adjust that. There's different numbers here of how much you want it to look antique. That makes it look very old. And we're going to take that back to zero. You can add a mat, and you can add how much of a mat you will like. You can vignette, same thing. And you can also blur the edges. Kind of gives it a neat effect. And you can fade the picture, fade the color out. You can boost the color. And you can do none. Adjust allows you to change the colors and the highlights and definition. And do many different things. Here's the temperature again. That's the one I use the most. Many of these things will mess up your picture unless you really know what you're doing. I recommend leaving them alone and using the Effects tab instead. The one time I recommend using it, though, is for temperature. You can see if a picture is too blue or too hot and too red or orange, you can drag it the opposite way and really make your picture that you thought was ruined look much better. Don't forget, you can always revert to the original and get back to exactly what you were doing before.